Do you want to limit the number of requests arriving to your APIs or route them to different resource paths? Would you like to service only those requests with a custom header without changing the backend implementation of your APIs? Bob sure would. His APIs get too many invalid requests, which is degrading the performance of his service. He needs to limit the access to his APIs and route some incoming requests. Luckily, Oracle API Platform Cloud Service can help. This service will help Bob to configure API policies so that he can manage the traffic, interfaces, and request routing of his APIs. Bob needs to add and configure three policies for his API. Those policies are API rate limiting, header validation, and resource-based routing. Once the configuration is complete, he needs to deploy or redeploy the API to a gateway and validate the applied policies. Here, Bob has implemented APIs through the API Platform Cloud Service Management Portal. From the API implementation page, Bob applies an API rate limiting policy to limit the incoming requests to his API. This policy enforces a limit on the total number of requests during a specified time interval. From a different policy category, Bob applies a header validation policy, which enforces the presence of values in the HTTP header of the incoming requests. In this case, the policy passes any request with a tenant ID header that has a value of 1 or greater. If the request doesn't include the header, or if it includes it with an invalid value, then it's rejected. Next, Bob applies a resource-based routing policy, which helps him to route the request to different service request URLs. When the users send their request to the estimate resource path, they'll be redirected to the corresponding service containing the estimate resource. Once the policies are applied, Bob proceeds to save the changes before deploying his API to a gateway. He's able to redeploy the latest iteration of his API because he has the proper grants to the gateway. After the API is deployed with the new policies, Bob validates them by using a REST client. Because he forgot to include the header and value the header validation requires, he gets an error. Once the header is included with the proper value, the result displays in the corresponding output from the implemented API. When the users send their request to the estimate resource path, they'll be redirected to the corresponding service containing the estimate resource. When Bob sends too many requests and reaches the defined limit, the API rate limiting policy is triggered and rejects the next incoming request until the invocation rate has dropped below the limit. To learn more, visit us online at cloud.oracle.com/API-platform. Thank you for watching.